One of the types of questions that students find most confusing are function-related questions. Remember back when we first learned about linear equations, we had this equation y equals mx plus b. Slowly, as we began to get into higher levels of math, we started to sub out this y and called it f of x instead. So to give you an example, we might have had an equation y equals x plus 2, which means this is the x value of the equation, and this is the y value equation, and these comprise of every single possible coordinate point on this graph. Well, all we're simply doing is changing the way that it looks. F of x represents your y value, and what's inside the parentheses represents your x value. So if I were to ask you for f of 2, you simply plug in this x value into every single x you see in the following equation. So we see it there. So that's what we plug in. And so f of 2 is equal to 4. If we have a more complicated equation, say f of x is equal to 2x squared plus x minus 2, and all of that is divided by x, and I'm asking you to figure out what f of 3 is equal to. Again, we're just going to plug in 3, since that takes the value of our x, into all of the x's we see in the subsequent following equation. So we have 2 times 3 squared plus 3 minus 2 divided by 3. So this becomes 18 plus 3 minus 2 divided by 3. That's equal to 19 divided by 3. Now the tricky part here is, let's use the same exact equation. What if instead I were to ask you for f of a? Now you might be wondering, where did that a come from? But this a just again represents your x value. Just like when you're given a numerical value 3, that represents your x value. So all they're asking you to do is plug in a every time you see x, just like we plugged in 3 every time we saw x in the following equation. So if we take the same equation and we're plugging in a for all the x's, we get 2a squared plus a minus 2 divided by a. So again, it doesn't really matter what letter this is. They could give us f of b or f of c or f of m, f of z. All of these, whatever's inside the parentheses, is your new x value, which we plug in to this x, x, and x. To take it one step further, let's say they give us f of m plus n. Again, this entire thing represents your x value. And so don't get confused by the addition sign or the fact that there are two new variables than before. We're just going to plug that into all of these x values. So we get 2 times m plus n squared plus m plus n minus 2 divided by m plus n. So again, always remember that f of x is simply just a y value. Whatever is inside the parentheses, however, is your x value. Whether that number inside the parentheses is an actual numerical value, like in this case 3, or in this case 2, or whether that thing inside the parentheses is a different variable, like an m or m plus n, you simply plug those into all of the x values that you see in the following equation.